Make sure to subscribe and hit that bell to stay notified when I'll be uploading. Did you click it? Hey guys, I'm going to be doing Oracle Factions Season 2 on the PS4, so make sure to go ahead and drop your PSN down in the description below. I'm going to be picking a lot of you guys from the comment section to be selected into the series, so make sure to go ahead and tell your friends also to leave their PSNs. I'm trying to get as many friends on the PS4 edition as possible so I can make some more maps for everybody to enjoy. Hello YouTube, welcome back to the video. It's going to be showing you guys the best seed for Minecraft Console Edition Aquatic Update. So this is going to be PS3, PS4, PS Vita, Wii U, Nintendo Switch, Xbox 360, and Xbox One. So this is going to be for all the console editions, and you guys can go ahead and get this seed. So hey guys, here's the shout out of the day, so make sure to go ahead and comment something nice and leave a like on the video and stay active on the channel, and I'm going to pick whoever's the most active on the channel for the next video. The settings for this world are large biome scale. You're going to also have to untick fine balance seed. And you're going to have to set the world size to small or classic. Either one works, but I definitely recommend small because on Xbox edition, like the Xbox One, if you set it to small, then you're going to get a few more things like a stronghold. And this map does have a stronghold, but only on the Xbox One for some reason. For some reason, I can't find it on here. I don't know why. I'm going to keep looking. All the coordinates for everything are going to be down in the description below. And the seed actually contains of 11 villages, 1 woodland mansion, 1 mineshaft, 1 stronghold, 7 desert temples, and 50 mob spawners, which is pretty insane. So let's go ahead and go around and show you guys the map. Everything's going to be down in the description so you guys can go ahead and get all the coordinates. So right here is the woodland mansion. Also right here is a glitch village, which is pretty cool. It glitches itself into the woodland mansion, as you can see. It glitches its way in. That's actually really cool, guys. I really do like the look of that. That looks really nice. Okay, here's the second village. It does have a blacksmith, so let's break in here. And it actually has some diamonds, iron chestplate, iron helmet, apples, which is actually pretty cool. But what's cooler about this village is it does have a mineshaft, which is right down here. So it has the cave spider spawner, and it has all the chests throughout, which is pretty cool. Right here is the first desert temple. So in here, we do have some gold. It does have 3 diamonds, which is pretty insane. It has emeralds, so 3 diamonds right here. And you guys can make your diamond pickaxe, start mining obsidian, and get to the nether pretty fast. Okay, guys, I just wanted to point out this really cool mining area. I'm going to leave the cords down in the description below. But as you can see, this is really cool. It has a lot of mining area, and it's going to be really cool for mining. Alright, so here's the fourth village. It doesn't have a blacksmith, but you can take all their crops, and I think that'll make up for it. Here's the fifth village, but it's not just a village. It has a desert temple right next to it. So if we drop down here, it doesn't have the best loot, but it does have a saddle in here. It has some emeralds, iron, rotten flesh, sand, gunpowder, even diamond horse armor. So you can get like a really cool horse. It has an enchanting book, and it has some more bones if you guys want to tame some dogs and some spider eyes. Right here, we have the fourth desert temple and the least exciting. So if we go down here, we have 3 emeralds, 3 gold, and this is where it gets really not exciting, where it's just rotten flesh, and then it's like that for all the other chests, so not really the best thing to be coming here, but you can get some golden apples, or just 1 golden apple, but you get some decent stuff, but not the best. Right here, we do have the 6th village, which is actually not that good, because it doesn't have a blacksmith, but you guys can come here to get the crops. Right here is the 7th village, and you can just get the crops from here, but it still is worth it coming here to get some extra food for your crops, and you could probably make something really big. Here's the 5th desert temple, so let's go ahead and break down here. So this is the 5th one. So as you can see what we have in here, not too good stuff. Gunpowder, you can get a golden apple from here, not too bad. And in general, this wasn't really too good. But for the book, I would actually come here, because Fortune 2 is pretty good, and has some emeralds, and it has the horse armor. But you guys can probably just go to all of these, just collecting everything before anybody else gets to here. But it also has the 8th village. Yeah, this is the 8th village, which is pretty insane. We're getting high up there in the village count. And this actually does have a blacksmith. So right here is the blacksmith. So let's break in here. And you get a couple of obsidian. You get 4 obsidian, iron leggings, and iron pickaxe. Right here is the 9th village. It does have a blacksmith, so in here you can find apples, bread, iron sword, iron helmet, iron pickaxe, and some iron ingots. Here's the seventh and final desert temple. So if we go down here, this one has to offer some rotten flesh, string, gunpowder, golden apple, and a golden ingot. And this one, some more gunpowder, spider eyes, bones, and one piece of sand. And here it has some sand, has bones, string, iron ingot, and iron horse armor. And this last chest has a saddle, which you guys can get multiple horses from these desert temples. So I definitely recommend coming out here. Some sand, bones, iron ingots, and some gunpowder. So that's about it for the desert temples. Let's try to find those last villages. Alright guys, that's going to wrap it up for this video. I'm going to find those two other villages. I'm going to put them down in the description below so you guys can go ahead and check them out. If they're not there, I'll just tell you guys, but I can't seem to find them, and I don't know if this is the 10th village. I kind of lost track after 9, so it's been getting kind of hard to find them, but I did find all the desert temples and everything else. So if you guys liked the video, make sure to go ahead and leave a like, and make sure to subscribe for some more Minecraft console edition content. I'm the only YouTuber that's keeping it alive, or one of the only YouTubers. But yeah, bye for now. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, and like the video. I'll see you guys next time on the next video. Bye. Kick it, Jackie Chan.